Hello, Anna. Long time no see.
Yep. It's been a whole year.
You've skipped work for a whole year?
Well, what do you know? I had another kid.
Ah! That would explain it. Mazel tov.
Thank you.
It's nice to have you back.
I'm very excited to be back. Rabbi, did I miss anything?
Did you miss anything? Because of, I assume you heard about COVID-19, a terrible pandemic, the shul's really basically been closed for over 3 months already, and we are just starting to reopen just for davening right now in the mornings with registration. So you missed that.
I see. So that will explain why I'm working from home and my overgrown front lawn?
Yes, that you should mow the lawn. That would explain why we are all working from home, my beautiful backyard here, I wish. And explain why we've been really doing all sorts of online programming recently, connecting with people new ways, lots of phone calls on your sites, really trying to engage with our community and keep them connected and supported during this challenging time.
I see, that explains a lot. So what keeps you up? What keeps you going during this crazy new world now, Rabbi?
Certainly the people of the shul do. That's a big part of it. And another thing which keeps me going is, even though I'm home all day with my kids, which is almost always great, I look forward every week to Shabbos dinner, and particularly the opportunity with Deborah to give my kids a blessing. You know, there's a tradition for parents to put their hands on their kids' heads and say the priestly blessing every Friday night. Actually, some people do one hand, some people do two hands, because priests, when they bless the community, use two hands. Some say you should actually only use one hand if you're not a Kohen, but don't worry about that so much. And particularly because this is a crazy time in a crazy world and things are hard for some people, it's really nice to connect with my kids and offer them words of a blessing that are deeply, deeply rooted in our tradition. So that's something I look forward to every week. And I hope that the members of our community of Adith Israel can connect with something, whether it's that, which is a nice thing, or something else, particularly on Shabbat, which you can look forward to each week. Something which is for you, but also for your family, whether it's blessing children or reaching out to a family member, something that keeps you resilient and gives you hope and gives you something to look forward to every week. And something else you can look forward to every week, Anna, is this video, because we're committed every week to continue to offer words of inspiration right before Shabbat. So Anna, that sound good to you?
Sounds great to me. Every Thursday, I'll see you here.
Whether I'll see you here in Killarney, you, your front lawn, or someone somewhere else, will be with you, members of Adith Israel, on your computer screens, iPods, etc. So that's it for now. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Until next Thursday, we miss you, Adith Israel families.
Stay safe, stay healthy. Hopefully we'll see you all sooner rather than later. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.